Welcome everybody. Today I'm going to talk about Italy and possible opening moves and opening strategies playing Italy. Italy is a country that sometimes is referred to as it falls in between. And literally it falls in between the southern triangle and the northern triangle. This is one of the reasons why many players consider playing Italy as a little bit boring. To a certain extent I agree, but that's not the whole story. The only two neighbors you have are France in the west and Austria in the east. There's some relationship with Germany or Tyrolia. And you have to take care of Turkey and what Turkey is doing in the eastern part of the Mediterranean. You could say you are neighbors with Turkey because Ionian Sea is your sphere of influence and Aegean Sea is Turkey's sphere of influence. Now you have a couple of different possibilities to open, or let's say directions in which you can open. You could open anti-French, anti-Austrian, or anti-Turkey. Each of it comes with its pros and cons. Let's have a look at the anti-Austrian opening first. A typical anti-Austrian opening would consist of the following. Army Venice moves to Tyrolia, Army Rome moves to Venice, and fleet Naples to Ionian Sea. If you've done your diplomacy correctly, Austria trusts you. So it's moving fleet Trieste to Albania to make sure it can conquer Greece in the fall. And hopefully it has decided to hold Vienna or move it to Galicia, or maybe Budapest in some weird case, but not to Trieste. Now, what is the benefit of this? In the fall, you are bordering with Tyrolia, both Vienna and Trieste, and you have Venice bordering Trieste. So you can either do a double attack on Trieste, or you can decide to move to both simultaneously. Furthermore, if you've talked to Russia properly, then Russia has moved to Galicia, which gives you a lot of benefit. So typically, after fall 91, the situation would be like this. You have conquered Trieste, meaning one extra supply center, and you've conquered Tunis, meaning you can build a new fleet in Naples and a new army in Venice. Italy, 5 supply centers, perfect result. However, I want to highlight the downsides here. The downside is Austria is severely weakened. You could almost say Austria is on its knees by now. It will have conquered Serbia normally, but it has lost Trieste, so basically it cannot build a unit. Meaning it only has 2 armies to defend against 2 Italian armies, 1 or 2 Russian armies, and a Turkish army. So Austria will be dead in fall 192 or fall 193. Now that's nice, you can probably grab Vienna while Austria is dying, so that's a good part. The bad part is, consider Turkey and Russia. What will their next move be? Now, Russia can move to Germany, maybe can fight England here in the north somehow. But Turkey has little other options than either to attack Russia or attack Turkey. Now, I think Turkey and Italy long-term are not a good fit. That has to do with they both want to dominate the Mediterranean. So they ultimately are always bound to attack each other. And now if you consider that, Turkey will think the same. So killing Austria too quickly will expose you to severe risks of both Turkey and Russia, in my opinion. Furthermore, they come from the east, they have no enemies in their back, and you still have France, who after 2 or 3 years could decide to come your way as well. So, going for a quick death of Austria, please make sure you have an alliance with Russia to go after Turkey next. That would be my primary advice here. Now what about anti-Turkish openings? Now the anti-Turkey opening requires patience, and that's often the main problem. So the anti-Turkey opening is called the Lipento opening. And the Lipento opening is basically focused on getting a army in Syria in the right bottom corner in fall 192. Now I'll show you in a minute how you do that. There is also a variety on this opening move, and that's the key Lipento. Now there's a separate movie about that because that involves lots of tricky details. Now the key thing in spring 91 is to move your army from Rome to Apulia, to not attack Austria because you need Austria in your attack on Turkey, and to move your fleet to the Ionian Sea. Now after the fall that looks like this, then you convoy your army from Apulia to Tunis, so to keep your fleet in the Ionian, and just don't attack Austria. In the best case, Austria takes Greece with its fleet in 191. Now you build a new fleet, you let Austria build armies, Turkey's probably building a fleet as well, but that's immediately tricky because Turkey has to defend the Aegean Sea against the fleet from Austria or the fleet of yourself in the Ionian Sea. So after that, you can move to the Eastern Mediterranean Sea and to Ionian Sea, and then finally, in fall 192, you can move your army to Syria. Now an army in Syria does not immediately give you a build, but Turkey now suddenly has an enemy in its back, and it's not used to that, and it's not made for that, so this will bring Turkey to its knees. Now, what's the main downside of this move? Especially for players that are just starting the game or only have played one or two games, it's patience. Because basically, during 1991 and 1992, all you will conquer is Tunis, and you will see countries around you like France, like Germany, like Russia, going to 5, 6, maybe already 7 supply centers. And Italian players tend to think that it's a bad thing, that they're not growing sufficiently fast. That's not necessarily true. As long as you keep France occupied with England or Germany, I don't know, somewhere in the Northern Triangle, you should be fine. But patience is important with the Lepanto opening. Furthermore, obviously your relation with Austria is important, and it would help you if Russia is occupied a little bit, either fighting Turkey, fighting England, fighting somebody next to Austria, basically. So yeah, anti-Turkey opening. It's quite popular, you see it happening quite a lot. Again, I refer to my other movie about the Kilo Panto opening. That's even more exciting, but especially playing Austria, you take a lot of risk. As Italy, the Kilo Panto opening is quite nice. Spoiler alert, the first move you make in Spring 91 is moving Army Venice to Trieste, so you can imagine Austria needs to trust you a little bit. Anti-French openings. Now, anti-French openings are quite straightforward. You move to Piedmont in Spring 91, and I would personally advise you to move to Tyrrhenian Sea in this case. Reason for that is that if you move to Ionian Sea, you kind of show to Austria you also have ambitions on that side and you want to make a reliable non-aggression pact with Austria. On the other hand, if you move to Tyrrhenian Sea, also the Turkish can understand very quickly that you're moving west, which means they could come west quite quickly as well, posing a threat to you. Now the next problem is, if you just fight France on your own, you stand no chance. Your army in Venice going to Piedmont will pose no risk to the French whatsoever. The best case is that they moved Marseille to Spain, and so they either go back and they bounce you, which is terrible, they can build a fleet in Marseille, or you decide not to bounce them, they move back to Marseille, they don't take Spain, but that's it. And France will get built from somewhere else, Portugal or Belgium. So the conclusion is you need help. Now, of course, you have a different situation if Germany decides to move to Burgundy and the English decide to move to the English Channel and maybe even to Wales, like I've shown here. Now, if you then resolve after Spring 91, you have this situation. Germany in Burgundy, Italy in Piedmont, and the English in the Channel. Now, this is a situation that has opportunities. France can do this, or England can do this, or can move to mid-Atlantic Ocean. Italy can move like this. Germany could either support that move or move to Paris. So now France has to make choices. Although you have to realize that if Army Marseille went to Spain, he's probably just moving back, so you need German support to really take Marseille. I believe this relatively, let's say, lousy position of Italy after Spring 1901 against France is the reason that only, let's say, 1 out of 10 openings that Italy plays are actually directed west. So most of the Italian openings are either neutral or towards the east, towards Austria or towards Turkey. Again, you need some good diplomacy and some good negotiating skills to get Germany and England to do the same. A perfect scenario in which I've seen happening is that they all decide to go for France. And after 1 or 2 years, Germany and England start a fight amongst themselves. That gives you the chance as Italy to wrap up this part of France, so Portugal, Spain and Marseille. You can move into the Atlantic Ocean quite quickly. And as long as everything on the east side is quiet, then you have a real position to play. However, it doesn't happen that often. And it basically involves first Germany and England to have an alliance, and after 1 or 2 years to break that alliance again. Now it happens, but it's rare. To recap, Italy has more opening moves than you think. You can go after Austria, you can go after Turkey, or you can go after France. But, and especially when you go after Turkey, you need patience. If you go after Austria, make sure you have a longer term strategy in mind what to do once Austria is dead, because Austria will die very quickly. It seems like a huge success, but you need a strategy after that. I hope you enjoyed this. There's more movies. Please join our YouTube channel and see you next time.